Welcome, everyone. Thank you for coming. This is our second Q&A session. We are really getting excited about the conference. Years of work are coming down to the finish line. We've got a short presentation to tell you about some of the goings-on that's going to be happening at the conference. We're going to answer a few questions that have been coming into the office, and then most importantly, we're going to get to your questions. If you think of any questions as we go, just type them into the chat. But would you please also put a capital Q in front of them so that we can see them more readily? That would really help us. There's three ways to enjoy the 2022 conference: the in-person conference in Sacramento, online at home, and on demand. In person, we're going to be meeting on the 24th through the 28th of May at the rebuilt state-of-the-art Safe Credit Union Convention Center. The conference hotels, they're right across the street. The Hyatt Regency does have a limited availability, but the Sheraton Grand is available. On Tuesday, we've got several tours scheduled. Get in the spirit of Western U.S. life by joining the all-day tour to the home of Yorba Wines, Shake Ridge Ranch in Amador Valley. It's California's Shenandoah Valley, they say. Meander through the vineyards and learn about the art and science of growing grapes for world-renowned California wines. A hearty picnic lunch is going to be served with a glass of wine, and you can also purchase a bottle or two if you wish. I've been told that this region is very well known for its Zinfandels. Afterwards, there's going to be a stop made at the historic town of Sutter Creek, established in 1850. A visit to Old Sacramento will send you back in time to the days of those living and working on the western frontier. This riverfront section of the city is filled with unique history and attractions that you may want to visit more than once. We'll meet at the Sacramento History Museum for the Old Sacramento Underground Tour. After lunch at the Rio Cafe, a waterfront cafe with outside seating, you'll be on your own to take in the rest of the sights Old Town Sacramento has to offer, including the Sacramento History Museum, the California Railroad Museum, the California Automobile Museum, and more. The museum admissions are not included. Both of these social events are being planned at outside venues. The Taste of California Welcome Reception will be in downtown Sacramento's Cathedral Square. You'll be able to socialize and taste in some of those California premium wines, accompanied by special hors d'oeuvres. Representatives from several California wineries are going to be available to provide answers to questions about the featured wines. There's going to be a tasting of three wines included. Additional wine can be purchased by the glass, and non-alcoholic beverages are also going to be served. Now, the Back to the 50s sounds like a really fun event. A casual dinner is going to be served in the courtyard of the California Museum. However, you are being encouraged to wear your favorite 1950s attire. Think happy days in Greece. Now, I heard through the grapevine that there's going to be a 50s trivia quiz with a prize for the winning table. So you might want to brush up on your 50s history. We want to thank the local host society, the California Genealogical Society, for all that they've been doing to support the conference and helping the conference committee with feet on the ground in Sacramento. They're the ones who are also planning all those wonderful tours and events that we just talked about. On their website, there's six recordings in the California Research Series. The Society managed to get those that are in charge of and those who use these facilities to provide an insider's look at the genealogy resources these great facilities have, and maybe even a few tricks of the trade. So if you're looking to do some research while you're in that area, you will really want to check out those recordings. Yes, we have got the speakers, and they are all eager to see you in person. You'll have the opportunity to choose from more than 160 sessions presented by 65 expert presenters. In a few minutes, we're going to have a tour of the agenda of the website, so you'll see even more. Not to be outdone, but online at home and on demand, we've got some really great lineup also here. And between all three ways of attending the conference, the selection of topics is also top-notched. Each year, the main focus is on a certain geographical area and research in that area. However, all NGS conferences contain many sessions on varied topics. This year, the tracks include land and maps, methodology, Europe and Middle Eastern, Western states, BCG skill building, and more. And that was just from one of the pages of the program. We've got something for everyone. On Wednesday, the conference kicks off with a really good start, a presentation by Dr. Gordon Chang speaking about the ghost of Gold Mountain, the epic story of the Chinese who built the Transcontinental Railroad. Now, this railroad made development of the West possible for anyone and changed transportation in the U.S. forever. You're not going to miss it. Also, some NGS awards are going to be given out at the opening session. And I've also been told that a few prizes are going to be given out. Far East, Deep South is an award-winning documentary produced by Larissa Lamb and Baldwin Chu. The film follows Chu's search for answers about his paternal ancestors that takes him on an emotional journey with his father through Mississippi. They not only discover surprising family revelations, but uncover the racially complex history of Chinese families during the Jim Crow era and the interconnected relationship between the Black and Chinese communities. Ultimately, they learn how deep their roots run in America. Cleveland, Mississippi is the scene for this movie, which is going to be shown on Friday, the 27th at 4 p.m. And we're introducing something new this year, social media badges. Feel free to download these badges and share with friends, family, and colleagues in your social media. Help NGS spread the news that you're joining us in Sacramento for the 2022 conference. You'll find them on the conference website under the Social Media and Press tab. We can't thank our sponsors enough. They've been so generous at the platinum, diamond, and silver levels. These are some of the wonderful exhibitors who's going to be in the expo hall in person and or virtually through the Hoover platform. Check back periodically to the conference page to see additional listings. And don't miss all of the fun in the expo hall. It's going to open at 6:30 p.m. Tuesday evening. Yes, it's going to open earlier than normal. We've been waiting to reconnect and socialize with one another and the vendors. The expo hall is also going to be open daily until Saturday afternoon. Now, I'm going to turn it back over to NGS Executive Director Matt Nanashis. He's going to take you on a tour of the online agenda powered by Hoover, the conference app.
Thanks, Ann. I'm going to take over screen sharing here and share my screen. I think everybody on the line has been to the conference website at conference.ngsgenealogy.org. I have seen all of the fun details on the website, and what I'm here to share with you tonight is just the information about the agenda. You may know that we will be using a different conference app this year, and it will also be the same program that will drive our online at home conference, and that is Hoover. And Hoover is providing us with the information about the agenda on our website tonight. You can see here, sessions are organized by date, starting on Tuesday, May 24th with our Focus on Society sessions, which are on the day before the main conference begins. Wednesday the 25th, Thursday the 26th, Friday the 27th, and Saturday the 28th. You can sort by any of those dates or all of those dates. You can also filter by room number, and I will give you a heads up now, these room numbers will be changing as we consolidate into area right above the expo hall. We'll be able to have everybody in one part of the building. You can filter by track, including all of the in-person events, all of the online at home events, or the Focus on Society events. If we want to take a look at just the in-person events, we click on that and we'll see them by date. What you'll see here is the date of the event, the time in Pacific time. So everything is presented in the event time zone, which is Pacific time. You'll see the session number, the session title, the track information, in-person and Chinese American track, the room number, which will change, the speaker and their affiliation, if any, and an explanation of their talk. You click on read more, you'll be able to see more details about that session. You can also click on the speaker's information and you'll see the bio of the speaker and all of the sessions that they are doing. So you'll be able to search our website much more readily for information about the agenda for online at home or in person or for the Focus on Societies event. So take a look at that. That is found under Program Agenda Sacramento. It's there, but it is both the agenda for Sacramento, online at home, and Focus on Societies. And then click on Sessions. So Program, Agenda Sacramento, and then Sessions in order to get to that spot. If anyone has any questions, I'm happy to answer those after we get to the Q&A session at the end. Thanks, Ann.
Thank you, Matt, so much for that tour. One thing also in that filtering, you can put the speaker up in the search box and you can search just by speakers. You might have also noticed a lesser designation at the end of each of the lecture descriptions. Each speaker targets lectures to a certain level of research expertise, from beginner to advanced to all. If genealogy is a relatively new endeavor for you, there are many lectures marked beginner, intermediate, and all, which you will be able to enjoy and learn from. If you're an experienced genealogist, you'll enjoy using the BCG skill building and methodology sessions. The speaker usually explains how they worked on and possibly solved their brick wall problems. Now, let's get to some questions. One question we've been getting is, what are the on-demand packages? The third way to enjoy the conference is the NGS on-demand option. The package details, the speakers and the topics, is going to be announced at a later date, and the recordings are going to be made available in July. The 20 and 40 session packages will be available for online viewing from July through the end of December 2022 on the Playback Now website. The 60 session package is also going to be available for online viewing from July through the end of December 2022 on Playback Now. However, you'll also receive a USB with the recordings. But please note, the 60 session package called The Works is only available if you register for the in-person or the online at home conference. And we've talked about that Hoover platform a number of times. Like Matt said, it is the conference app. Now, if you've attended NGS conferences in the past, you might remember those conference apps. Well, take them and add more features and you've got the Hoover platform. You'll be able to access information about the speakers, the attendees. Online at home is going to also be able to access the virtual program, the expo hall, and connect with attendees in person at home. Links and instructions for loading the conference compendium and the Whova app is going to be sent about 10 days before the conference. So you'll be able to set up your profile on Whova before the conference and begin connecting before you arrive. By reviewing the speaker submissions about each lecture in advance, you can select the presentations which are going to be most helpful for your personal growth. Another question, does NGS have a COVID policy? Yes. Proof of vaccination and boosters as applicable and masks indoors is going to be required. Now, you're here tonight, so we know you've got questions. So we're going to open up for questions. If you type your question in the chat, please put a capital Q in front of it so that we can see it more quickly. You can also use the raise your hand option that Zoom provides in the reactions function. When we call on you, then you can open your mic. The reactions function is normally in the lower right-hand corner. The NGS panel members tonight are Jan Alpert, the NGS Conference Committee Chair, Matt Menashes, NGS Executive Director, Matt Berry, the NGS 2022 Conference Chair, Jane Lindsay, the Local Host Society Chair, and Courtney Holmes, the NGS Conference Registrar. So, start typing in your questions.
All right, Ann, we got our first question was related to the COVID policy. I saw that your COVID policy was effective January 10th and then revised. Was wondering if you expect any additional revisions as we get closer to the conference. Jan, do you want to take that?
Hi. We're following the CDC guidelines for vaccinations and boosters. So at this point, for example, the CDC is not requiring the second booster, but if they were to require that while there was still time, then we would add that requirement. But to me, it doesn't look like that's going to happen. But if there are increases in COVID in around the country, then that is a possibility. But we are not expecting to remove the requirements between now and the conference. We have an older group of genealogists. I'm one of those. I'm 75 years old. And therefore, we want to protect the health and safety of all the speakers and the attendees. And we feel following the CDC policy is the best position for us to take. And that's the position our board of directors approved in January. Matt, Jan, I don't know if you wanted to add to that.
Yeah, Jan, could you just, there's one other question that asks, will speakers wear masks while speaking? And you might speak to that exception and also to the eating and drinking exception.
Okay, so we've already communicated to the speakers that in a letter that went out this week that they will not be wearing masks, but we are having the speaker at the podium and mic to be far enough removed from the first row of where the seats are. But the speakers have been told that once they're done speaking, then they will be wearing masks. And also, we're not requiring masks, obviously, when people are eating. And we, at a meeting today, we talked about having in each of the luncheons and the banquet, we will have several tables with more spacing in the seating. In other words, we will have tables so that if you're with friends and you want to sit with a friend, and if you're by yourself and you want to just sit four or five people at a table, we will have that choice as well.
Question for those on the panel who've attended NGS conferences before. This is my first conference. What do you suggest newbies bring with them? And it will be my first NGS conference as well.
We always tell you to wear socks and bring a sweater. Because one thing we have found is the convention centers begin the day very cold. And then as the day progresses, it gets warmer. But we have people who come in sandals and then they find and a short sleeve shirt and they find they're cold. So layer, you know, bring a sweater, and we're going to give everybody a bag. That's one of the things that always happens. And you'll be happy to have your bag so that you can put your jacket or sweater in the bag if it warms up in the afternoon.
All right. Also, go ahead, Ann.
Also, don't forget to bring your notebook or your tablet, whatever you take notes on.
Excellent suggestion. And comfortable shoes.
Yes, comfortable shoes.
Yes. Always bring more than one pair of shoes. So I usually get about 10,000 steps a day going through the convention center because I'm going from room to room and checking the meals and so forth. So you'll find your feet don't get as tired if you can wear one pair of shoes one day and another pair the next day. And I also wanted to tell everybody, I'm not sure it was clear on the HUVA explanation, but you're going to have the compendium, which is going to have all of the speaker handouts in them. But the app is also going to have the handout with each speaker. So you can, once you decide which speaker you're going to listen to, you have your tablet. If I have time to listen, I go in and I sit down and I immediately pull up that handout. And I like to use the little draw thing that I have on my iPad because I can underline it. I can take notes. But anyway, that's what I encourage you to do.
Great. But next question is for Jane Lindsay. Jane, if you could unmute. We didn't mention the Tuesday day tour to Gold Rush Country. Is that still planned?
Yes, it's still planned. Unfortunately for some, it's sold out. It was quite popular. And Grant Dinn, who's doing some talks on Chinese, is an expert in the Gold Country, and he is going to be your host on that tour. So I think it's going to be a great tour. Sorry, we can't do another one.
Fantastic. Next question. I think this one might be for me. Do you have to watch the online at home sessions that day, or can you watch them at a later date? You can watch them later. The sessions are pre-recorded, but the Q&A will be live the day of, and then we will be posting the pre-recorded session so that it can be watched after it actually occurs. Thing that you can do is if you've got online at home sessions competing against each other, you can go back and watch one that was at the same time. So that extends the amount of content that you'll be able to have for online at home. This question's for Courtney. Courtney, I registered a long time ago and I don't remember what I decided to pay for. I'm sure I got an email, but have no idea where it is. Can I find out what I did?
Hi, Gary. Yes, I will pull your record up and resend your email confirmation with the list of all the sessions that you've purchased.
All right.
Following the call.
And I'd like to add for anybody on here, if you have registered and you said, oh, now I want to come take a tour or I want to go to the 50s party, you can still do that. So registration closes at April 18th. So and as you heard, we have the research trip is closed and the Gold Country trip is closed. So we encourage you, if you want to do something, to sign up in the next few days because other things may also fill.
Yes, and you can also log into your NGS profile and select purchases and you'll see a list of what you've purchased, but I will send you an email confirmation so you have that in your records.
Thank you, Courtney. Next question from Chad. I just downloaded the HUVA app on my phone. When should the NGS program get added to it? Or at the least, I haven't found it yet. So Chad, really good question. We will publish the NGS event right around May 1st. So it will publish around May 1st and you will be able to then go in and start communicating. There's some things you'll be able to do even before we get to Sacramento or we get to online at home. So it will publish on May 1st. And the other thing you should be aware is you will receive emails from us probably on May 10th and then in the week before the event with details on the app and what you should be doing in advance of the meeting. We're not going to send those out when it publishes, but you, if you have the app, you'll be able to see the event on May 1st. So the next question is about, is it foreseen that on Tuesday there will be a Librarians Day? Is it possible to present this virtually? This is from Becky at the Talbot County Free Library. Becky, great question. Jan, do you want to address that?
Well, we have replaced Librarians Day with something called SLAM, which is Societies, Libraries, Archives, and Museums. And that's going to be later in the afternoon after Focus in Societies closes. And are we going to record, I don't know, are we going to record that program, Matt, to where other people can see it?
The SLAM program?
Yeah, are we going to?
So all the
videos will be recorded.
The videos will be available on the Whova app and in at the convention center to watch, along with the posters will be available at the convention center. Those will be digitally displayed along with available on the Whova app.
But this, we've replaced Librarians Day with a broader program that allows societies, museums, libraries to compete. And we have awards or recognitions for each of those. And that's what Matt's talking about. So we're going to recognize the five or six best submissions, and then they'll be available for viewing.
Next question. Go ahead.
Well, I was going to answer. Mary says, I bought the full package. I don't remember picking the sessions. So we are working, I mean, we're doing the in-person conference and online at home in May. And then in June, you will receive an email from Playback Now giving you the opportunity to make your selections. So we do this for a couple of reasons. One is that some of the people who purchase it actually go to in-person and they may not know what they're going to view in person, and some of them are in both places, and that gives them a chance to then pick the ones they're going to pick on demand that they did not have an opportunity to see. So it works better. Otherwise, people would be picking early and then they come back to us and want to make changes. So that will be available in June. And they'll be, as Matt said, you can view them July through December.
Next question was related to the Whova app. Does it create an opportunity to create your own personal agenda? And does it allow you to take notes? Yes, it does allow you to create your own personal agenda, which will be saved in the app. You'll see a tab when you get the app, it'll say full agenda, and then it'll have my agenda right next to it. So as you select the agenda items from the full agenda, they will appear in your agenda, so it's simpler for you to follow along with. In addition, when you put them in your agenda, it also gives you an option to download those to a Google Calendar or an iCal or any calendar program, so it can go into your regular normal calendar program as well. I don't know the answer to the question about whether you can take notes within the Whova app, and I will try and get that information out to everybody as part of all of the information that we send in advance of the conference. next question. Well, I think that's all the questions we've had submitted.
Well, there was one about, is there a way to submit evaluations for sessions?
Oh, yes.
You have two ways. As you watch a session, you can pull up the evaluation and answer it right then, which is what I encourage people to do, because as you've listened to 10 of them, then they start to blend. So it's much better to do it when you listen. And also on the Playback Now program that we do July through December, they have the evaluations there also. So you can at any time listen to a particular session and evaluate the speaker right then. Then in addition to all that, when the conference is over, we will send a questionnaire, usually like 3 days later, because we want to give people a chance to get home. And then that gives us feedback. And we do give the speakers the feedback. We share the results with the speakers because we want the speakers, if there is something that can be improved upon, we want them to do that. They don't see individual responses, but they see the overall comments. So I hope that answered your question.
Couple other questions. First one, do you have a head count as to how many people have signed up to attend in person in Sacramento? We do. We expect attendance will be lower than at a normal NGS conference post-pandemic. We would expect attendance probably is going to be around half of what we would normally see to perhaps even less than that. So we would hope we have about 600 or 700 people when all is said and done. We have about another month, another month of registration. So if you haven't registered, or another, not month, 3 weeks, 2 weeks till the 18th. So if you haven't registered, we encourage you to do that as soon as possible. Can you go into more detail about why NGS decided to do poster sessions instead of the traditional Librarian's Day? Yes, that's a good point. Why did we do that? They do seem to be two different things. In part, we are not doing Librarian's Day right now in the pandemic because many public agencies still have not allowed their employees to travel yet. And the delegate council, librarians who are members of NGS, there's a delegate from every member organization. That'll be something that the delegate council will explore as to when and if we bring back Librarians Day as a separate event. The next question was, this is a question about the Whova app, and it's asking somebody to register to see the NGS conference. Yeah, you can ignore that. You're already registered. You don't need to worry about what the Whova app is saying. All of the registrants who've come in through the registration process will be uploaded into the Whova app. You cannot register for the NGS conference in the Whova app itself. Next question is for Jane Lindsay. I'm a volunteer on site. When will there be an orientation?
I actually think Jan might answer that better. We're setting up virtual orientation for all the volunteers, and that probably will be happening sometime in probably early May. We also will have good explanations of each job description. So I think that you'll be hearing from Chris or Maureen.
Yeah, one of the things we're waiting on, as Matt said, we were going to be using a set of rooms farther away from the exhibit hall. So we have consolidated now so that the meeting rooms will be up the escalator from where the exhibit hall is. And so the room numbers are changing, and we've got to get all that straight before we put the volunteer video together, because the rooms are changing. And then everybody's going to get that. The schedule that you've seen online under program is going to be updated, not the whole brochure, but the schedule, and that will be at the beginning of the compendium, and then we'll put it again on the website with all the correct room numbers. So that'll happen in early May.
Okay, Carol Lee has had her hand up, and so I'm gonna ask her to unmute and ask her question live, and then we've got at least one other in the chat.
Hi, I'm Carol Lee, and I am with Root Cellar Sacramento Genealogical Society. It's only 93 degrees today, just to let you know, so a tad bit warm, about 20 degrees more than it should be. It isn't so much a question. I just want to let you know, as library chair, Root Cellar, like many of your societies, receives book donations for your libraries. And many times these are books that you have already in your collection. In other words, they're a duplicate. I would love to talk to you, any of you, either in person or via the chats, etc., to see if you would like to swap your duplicate books with ours. And I've done this with other library other societies, primarily here in California, but I've gone all the way back to Missouri. So just thought I'd let you know, we'll have that and we'll have a table available. If you have any questions about the library, you can come to our table. I'll have maps so you can find it if you have time in between the different sessions. So that's all I had to say, and I'll let everybody go to the next question.
Thanks, Carol Lee. Next question, Jane, if you need volunteers, will you advise them what is needed? I'm happy to assist. You want to point them to the right place?
Yes. we have an app or a program called Sign Up, and I'm not 100% sure if it's on the NGS site. We talked about that, but if you go to the California Genealogical Society, it's californiaancestors.org. I'll type it in. There's a whole dedicated page to the conference, and the hot link there is available to sign up. And we are having a good bit of people helping out, but we really would like to have, a lot of people that would be able to fit their volunteer times in between their classes. And I do want to say, Carol Lee, her group was the local host committee chair the last time it was in Sacramento. So they're quite an active group, and I'm so pleased that they'll have a table there. There are also another group called the Sacramento Regional Genealogical Council, which consists of about 16 other genealogical societies that are right around in the Sacramento area, who are all going to be there at their table helping you to find where you need to go for your particular county in the Sacramento area. And we have a lot of other good things too. I think it's really nice that NGS is planning a lot of really good, like, networking and personal interaction kinds of options. And I think you'll be so pleased at some of the things that are going to be happening. So I won't go into it now because we have a limited time, but please know that it's going to be a really exciting conference.
Thanks, Jane. There was one question we missed from Mary Evans that we've caught now. With the full package, do they have to wait to June to view the online at home session? So let's make sure we get our just explain a couple of terms. There's a distinction between online at home and on demand. So the online at home sessions will be essentially live on Friday and Saturday, the 27th and 28th of May. The on-demand packages, if you bought an on-demand packages, those will stream starting July 1st, 2022. You'll be able to choose your sessions, as Jan said, starting in June. So you'll be able to select either your 20, your 40, or if you're getting the full package of 60, you don't need to worry about it. You'll be able to select those sessions in June, and they'll start streaming July 1st and are available up until December 31st, 2022. You must watch your sessions by December 31st, 2022.
Unless you
bought the works when you...
And then you'll be watching on your computer using your USB.
Correct. Let's see. When do you expect the syllabus to be released? Early May. Jan, do you want to explain the change in terminology and when that'll be coming out?
Yeah, we're calling it a compendium because we're putting everything in it. We used to give you a syllabus or an electronic syllabus and a program. We had a printed program, but we're trying to move everybody to the Hoover app, and we're putting the kinds of information that used to be in the printed program into our document that we're now calling the compendium. So what that means is we're going to talk about all the exhibitors in there, we're going to have the bios of the speakers, we're going to have the schedule, and we're going to have all the speaker handouts in the compendium. So it will not be called a syllabus, and we hope to have it out on May 10th. That's our target date.
So it will be available for download via email on or about May 10th. It will also be available, presumably, in the Hoover app. So if you haven't downloaded it from your email, when you get on site, you can download it from within the Hoover app. And as Jan said earlier, each of the lectures, their particular handouts will be attached to those lectures in Hoover as well. So you don't have to scroll through 600 pages of PDF. You'll just be able to go straight to that one.
Right. And then the online at home handouts are also in the compendium, but the on-demand handouts are not. Those are what you get when you see the live streaming. So I know it's confusing, but just think about the in-person conference and online at home as being a May program, and think of on-demand as the second half of the year, and then you'll it'll help you understand what's in the compendium and what's not.
Matt Berry has dropped the link to the volunteer sign up into the chat. So if you're interested, I think Janie Sue had interest in volunteering. The link to the volunteer sign up is right in the chat for you. Let's see, we have, how is the works different? We're all very confused by it.
Okay, shall I try it again?
Try it again.
And yes, I do have one of those voices that falls off at the end. So we're going to be offering 60 sessions. If you buy the works, you can watch those 60 sessions live streamed. And one of the advantages to me of live stream is if you have a smart TV, you can watch it on your big screen, which is what I like to do. So the difference is if you pay for the works, you get all of them, and you get them, all 60 of them, on a USB that then plugs into your laptop, and you can listen forever. But because this is really such a benefit, we're only offering it to people who either come to in person and also or sign up for online at home. In other words, you can't just stay home and get the works package. You can get 40, but you can't, or 20, but you can't get the USB.
So just to clarify one thing, Jan used the term live stream the on-demand. Actually, those are not live, so to speak. They're streamed on-demand at your request starting July 1st. And again, the benefit of buying the works is you can stream it, but you're also going to get the same content on a USB that you can keep forever.
Yeah, and the on-demand does not have a live Q&A. So the advantage of online at home, which Anne has so graciously agreed to host, is that each speaker, you will have an opportunity to ask them live Q&A. So that's the benefit of online at home.
There's another question, Courtney, this one might be for you. Chad added the USB thumb drive to his shopping cart, but is wondering if he needs that given the download option. And I'm gonna assume he's talking there about the compendium.
He is talking about the compendium, and it is the exact same information. It is historically been called the syllabus, and we do put it on the flash drive, and we've always sent it out electronically about 10 days before the conference. So it is the same information. However, people do like to keep it and be able to pull it up whenever they want and forever. And you can do that if you have a USB. So we always have plenty of people who do want that and purchase it. Okay. And that will be distributed at the conference at the registration table when you pick up your registration packet.
Excellent. Thank you. Are there any other questions that anybody would like to put their hand up and ask live for our esteemed panel? Still occasionally getting somebody who's just joined.
I wanted to point out to everybody that if you look at Matt Berry, that's the building. That's where we're going to be, in the convention center. So it is new and it's renovated. And I also wanted to say that the theme that's on the cover of the brochure is taken from a mural that's there. So if you're going to be there in person, you will get to see why we picked that theme and how we carried it forward. So.
The mural on the brochure is on the Sacramento Municipal Utility District building. a mile or so away from the convention center. Yeah, a little more. Yeah. It's a beautiful piece of.
But it's a wall. It's a huge mosaic.
Wraps around three sides of the building.
It's a building.
So if you're interested in outdoor art, it's highly recommended. If you're interested in municipal utilities, it's definitely recommended.
May I say one thing the 50s party?
Absolutely.
They describe the 50s party very nicely in the book, but the thing that I'm excited about is that we're going to have some cutouts so that you can come in, and even if you don't wear your costume, you can put your head in this cutout and you can be a 50s person. And we're also going to do the trivia quiz that we mentioned. And we also are going to have special placemats in honor of the 1950 census.
And I bought a pool skirt, so I have.
No, you did. I'm wearing pedal pushers and a nice blouse with a collar and a scarf. That's what I think I used to wear.
All right. Let's see. Mary asks, so does the work get all of that? At this point, I don't know what I paid for. Mary, we'll have Courtney get in touch with you and make sure that she explains what you've ordered. So Mary Evans Little, Courtney will be in touch with you tomorrow and share with you what you've already purchased. All right, anybody else want to put their hand up and ask a live question?
Matt, there is one question above that from Judy about being confused about the USB for the compendium.
I'm confused. I'll let Courtney answer the question.
Hi. So there is a USB for the compendium, which is different than the USB for the works for on demand. There's only a USB for the 60 package of the works that can only be purchased if you order an in-person or an online registration. The USB compendium is the same as what you can download and what will be on the WHOVA app, but it is a USB that you can keep forever and you will pick up if you are in person in Sacramento. The USB for the works will be mailed to your home sometime in June, Jan?
Well, probably.
The beginning of July?
Yeah.
So they both have USBs, but they both contain different information.
One has print material, the one of the compendium. The USB with the works has video. It's a huge file.
All right. Did we miss any questions in the chat that anyone would like us to address, or is there any final questions live?
If you pay $10, it says, what did we pay $10 for? That would be the compendium.
That's correct.
So here's the advantage. I have the compendiums on the flash drives, but I'm a heavy researcher. And so what I use it for is if I am encountering a certain topic, I think, oh, I wonder which conference I went to where that was. And I have them all on flash drives and I can find the material for the topic I'm looking for much easier than if I have it on a, you know, just saved on my computer. That's why. But it's a convenience if you go back and refer to the handouts over particular topics. And I particularly use that for the BCG skill building. They have really good examples, and sometimes I encounter similar examples in my research and I don't know. I know there was a lecture when I want to find that and then I can. That's all. It's a convenience.
Okay, this next question looks like Janie Sue is asking, what are the hours for vendor booths daily, and do we set up prior to opening? I'm assuming, Janie Sue, that you are an exhibitor from that question, is that correct? And you can unmute yourself. Well,
Yes, we are.
Yes, excellent.
National Society Descendants of American Farmers.
That's what I thought. So you will be receiving information from Karen Forbes, our exhibits coordinator, with information about booth setup and from our exhibition company, Valley Expo, with ordering information for any additional items you may want for your booth, like electricity if you need it, additional chairs or things like that. So you will be receiving all of that directly from Karen Forbes and from Valley Expositions. That'll include the setup. Setup will be Tuesday morning. That'll be the setup is Tuesday morning in order for the show doors to open at 6:30 p.m. that evening. And then exhibitors can be at their booths throughout the event. But the main times are during breaks and during lunch when you would expect the hall to be more packed with attendees.
And the exhibit hall, the expo hall is opening Tuesday night for 2 hours.
Correct. Okay. Any other questions? If not, Ann, I'll hand it back to you.
Super. Thank you so much. We hope that we've answered all your questions. If not, if you think of another one, just let us know at ngsgenealogy.org. And if you're an NGS member, you can use the forum community to ask your question. We look forward to seeing all of you in Sacramento online at home or through on demand. Thank you to the NGS panel, and thank you to every one of you who joined us tonight. Have a good weekend.